is there a big difference between a private, I know a wage garnishment is a process by which some type of plaintiff executes some type of judgment against a defendant. Now, can you tell me the differences between a private wage garnishment and a government wage garnishment?
Yeah, good question.
Well, the main difference is that a wage garnishment that comes from somebody who is not a government entity means that you have been sued in usually a state court, and then that person has a judgment against them through an order issued by a state court. Once they have an order, at that point, they can execute on that order and collect on that judgment. If you are dealing with back taxes or child support or debt from student loans that you did not pay on, the government does not have to sue you. So if you fall behind in paying that debt, what can happen is that they can immediately start to garnish your wages, and that's without filing a lawsuit.
Right, and you can't avoid that. I mean, if we're talking student loans or child support, I know you handle divorce cases. I mean, you know, if people fall behind with child support and there's a wage garnishment judgment, you're not getting out of that.
Well, that's right. Now, you're not going to bankrupt a child support judgment, but what Sherry's talking about with respect to a child support garnishment not requiring a judgment applies, and correct me if I'm wrong on this, Sherry, but I think this is right. There is a mechanism in Alabama for the Alabama Department of Human Resources to do a direct draft of your bank account, for example, through a garnishment. That doesn't require a prior judgment. Now, if your ex-wife is not signed up with DHR, then she's going to have to get a judgment against you before a garnishment can be issued against you. Mm-hmm. But the same thing can happen on student loans and some government entities as well. So.